He is Lord, He is Lord. He is risen from the dead, and He is Lord. Every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. He is Lord, He is Lord. He is risen from the dead, and He is Lord. Good morning, folks. Good morning, Sister Danette, Brother Charles. Good morning, Brother Roy and family, Brother Roel. Good to see you all this morning, bright and early. Amen and amen. Good morning, mi amorcita. That's my wife. I have to make sure y'all know that. Good morning, Sister Mickey McClure. Good morning, Sister Wendy, Sister Kaylin. Good to see you all joining this morning. What a wonderful day. Sitting in my backyard, birds chirping. My dog got tired of trying to get my attention, so we went over to eat his breakfast. I'm looking up and I can see the moon still. I can still see the moon up there. It's a beautiful morning. Good morning, Sister Donna, Brother Allen. What a blessing. What a wonderful morning. Good morning, Brother Randy. Yes, He is risen indeed. Brother Dale, good to see you this morning. Good to see you, folks. What a blessing, what a blessing. Happy Resurrection Sunday. Happy Easter. He is risen. Why seek ye the living amongst the dead? He is risen. What a blessing this morning. Just want to share a couple thoughts with you. From the Word of God, we'll be in Luke 24. And then after Luke 24, we will be going to John 20. Luke 24 and then John 20. Luke 24 and then we'll go to John chapter number 20. Amen. Good morning, Sister Gustin. All the way from the frozen north of Texas. Not that frozen. Amen. Good to see you this morning. What a blessing. Luke 24. And then we'll go to John 20. We'll start in Luke 24, verses 1 through 10. Now upon the first day of the week, very early in the morning, they came unto the sepulchre, bringing the spices which they had prepared and certain others with them. And they found the stone rolled away from the sepulchre. And they entered in and found not the body of the Lord Jesus. And it came to pass, as they were much perplexed thereabout, behold, two men stood by them in shining garments. And as they were afraid and bowed down their faces to the earth, they said unto them, Why seek ye the living among the dead? He is not here, but is risen. Remember how He spake unto you when He was yet in Galilee, saying, The Son of Man must be crucified into the hands of sinful men, and be crucified, be delivered into the hands of sinful men, and be crucified, and the third day rise again. And they remembered His words, and returned from the sepulchre, and told all these things unto the 11, and to all the rest. It was Mary Magdalene, and Joanna, and Mary the mother of James, and other women that were with them, which told these things unto the apostles. Then we'll go over to John chapter number 20. John chapter number 20. John 20 verses 1 through 18. John 20 verses number 1 through 18. John 20, 1 through 18. The first day of the week cometh Mary Magdalene early, when it was yet dark, unto the sepulchre, and seeth the stone taken away from the sepulchre. Then she runneth and cometh to Simon Peter and to the other disciples whom Jesus loved, and saith unto them, They have taken away the Lord out of the sepulchre, and we know not where they have laid Him. Peter therefore went forth, and that other disciple, and came to the sepulchre. So they ran both together, and the other disciple did outrun Peter, and came first to the sepulchre. And he, stooping down and looking in, saw the linen clothes lying, yet went he not in. Then cometh Simon Peter following him, and went into the sepulchre, and seeth the linen clothes lie, and the napkin that was about his head, not lying with the linen clothes, but wrapped together in a place by itself. Then went in also that other disciple, which came first to the sepulchre, and he saw and believed. For as yet they knew not the scripture that he must rise again from the dead. Then the disciples went away again unto their own home. But Mary stood without at the sepulchre, weeping. And as she wept, she stooped down and looked into the sepulchre, and seeth two angels in white sitting, the one at the head and the other at the feet where the body of Jesus had lain. And they say unto her, Woman, why weepest thou? She saith unto them, Because they have taken away my Lord, and I know not where they have laid him. And when she had thus said, she turned herself back, and saw Jesus standing, and knew not that it was Jesus. Jesus saith unto her, Woman, why weepest thou? Whom seekest thou? She, supposing him to be the gardener, saith unto him, Sir, if thou have borne him hence, tell me where thou hast laid him, and I will take him away. Jesus saith unto her, Mary. She turneth herself and saith unto him, Rabboni, which is to say, Master. Jesus saith unto her, Touch me not, for I am not yet ascended to my Father. But go to my brethren, and say unto them, I ascend unto my Father and your Father, and to my God and your God. Mary Magdalene came and told the disciples that she had seen the Lord, and that he had spoken these things unto her. Can you sense in the beginning of these passages the loss of these ladies? I mean, they can't sleep. They're rising up before the sun comes up. They're going and preparing and being there, and it's still dark. I can imagine that over those 3 days, it must have felt like an eternity. They had loss, they had grief, they had pain. They had lost their Lord. They had believed in him. And I believe that they still had some faith, but their faith was shaken. And then they get to the tomb, and it's desecrated. The stone's gone. His body is gone. They think he's been stolen, or they've moved him. I mean, just the loss, the grief, the pain. Their faith is shaken. They've lost their Lord. His tomb is desecrated. But then they get a message, a special message given by God's messengers. Those angels were there, and they said, Why seek ye the living among the dead? He is not here, but he is risen. I think many times in religion, they're looking for the living amongst the dead. Dead ritual, dead practice, dead tradition, dead words of men. When what they ought to be doing is looking for the living Lord. And he is not dead. But you know, even though they had this message from the angels, they still just, it seemed too good to believe. Mary still couldn't grasp. They had said, he's alive. Why seek ye the living amongst the dead? But she can't grasp that. It seemed like, later it says, when they went to the disciples, it seemed like they were telling idle tales. And they didn't believe them. John didn't believe it until he ran into the tomb or came to the tomb. Mary didn't believe it till she actually saw the Lord. It was hard to believe, even though they had heard him speak of his death and his resurrection. Even though they knew the Old Testament scriptures, it was hard for them. And folks, there's times when it's hard. Our faith is shaken. It seems like the Lord is not here. And it's hard to believe. But why seek ye the living amongst the dead? He is not here, but he is risen. And so they all come, they see, Peter leaves, John leaves, the other ladies leave. But Mary just can't leave. She just can't leave. I mean, maybe, I don't know, she had such a deep love for the Lord. Maybe it was because she had been forgiven so much. This lady of the street, this lady who had been pulled out of the very filth of this world. She just can't leave that garden. She just can't leave that tomb. He had forgiven her of so much. He had saved her from so much. And we see here in John 20, verse number 11, but Mary stood without at the sepulcher weeping. And as she wept, she stooped down and looked into the sepulcher, and seeth two angels in white sitting, the one at the head and the other at the feet, where the body of Jesus had lain. And they say unto her, Woman, why weepest thou? She saith unto them, Because they have taken away my Lord, and I know not where they have laid him. She still believed he was her Lord. But it was hard for her to believe he was alive. And when she had thus said, she turned herself back and saw Jesus standing, and knew not that it was Jesus. Jesus saith unto her, Woman, why weepest thou? Whom seekest thou? She, supposing him to be the gardener, saith unto him, Sir, if thou have borne him hence, tell me where thou hast laid him, and I will take him away. Jesus saith unto her, Mary. Oh, when she heard her name coming from his lips, she hadn't recognized him before. But he personally said, Mary. The wonderful thing about the risen Savior is he is the Savior of all mankind, of all those who will believe. But he is a personal Savior. Oh, when he calls your name. I remember the night he called my name. I've heard his voice over the years. When he says my name, and she hears the name coming from his lips, Mary. And she turns and she recognizes the Lord. And everything changed when she saw the Lord. Everything changed when she saw the Lord. I'll tell you this right now. For me, everything changed when I really saw the Lord. Not when I knew about him. Not when I knew facts about him or the word about him. But when I saw him. When I knew him, everything changed. And for Mary, everything changed. When she heard him say, Mary, and she turned and saw him and recognized him. Oh, we serve a risen Savior who can be seen. Right now, we must see him through eyes of faith. But one day it will be face to face. But I remember when I saw the Lord. I remember when I heard him call my name. And it changed everything. She went from weeping to joy. She went from shaken faith to solid faith. She went from wondering if she'd ever see him again to knowing she would live forever. Mary. It changed for everyone else later in this passage when he stands in the midst of them. They went from fear once again to faith. They went from shaken to solid, and they went from sadness to joy. He's alive. He's alive. Thomas, who would not believe until he saw, when Jesus showed him his hands and his feet, how Thomas changed. He went from faithlessness to faithful. He went from, I won't believe, and I don't even want to meet with you all, to being a man willing to die for his faith. We serve a risen Savior. He is more than just a figment of someone's imagination. He is more than just an idea. He is alive, and he is real, and he is either your personal Savior or wants to be your personal Savior. Hallelujah! He rose from the dead. He is alive. Why seek ye the living amongst the dead? But he is risen. And he is calling your name. And he is personal to you. If you're saved, rejoice. There's no need for sadness and fear. Rejoice. If you're lost, come to the risen Savior. He's calling your name. just like he called Mary's name. What a wonderful, wonderful thought. Why seek ye the living amongst the dead? But he is not here, but he is risen. We will see you again at 10:30 and then at 11. 10:30 is going to be exciting, folks. I've been putting together this program, thinking about it for 2 weeks, putting it together the whole last week. Have some interesting guests that you're going to hear from, and a wonderful time of music and poems and greetings. And then at 11 o'clock, a wonderful morning service focusing on the resurrection. We'll see you at 10:30 and then at 11. I love you, praying for you. Remember, he is risen. Why seek ye the living amongst the dead?